What's up, YouTubers? EpicConspiracy here. Today we're going to be reviewing Whitney, the season premiere. It stars, writes, created everything by Whitney Cummings. She's a comedian. She got pretty famous and got a bunch of shit really fast. It was about a year ago she was on Howard Stern. She was on the hottest, funniest comedian contest. There was like four girls there, and she actually didn't even win. She came in second place. That was the first time that I ever heard of her name. I'm a big Howard Stern fan. Very shortly after that, from that appearance, she got booked to do a couple roasts, and she got some fame there for, you know, telling some jokes that she wasn't supposed to tell. And the guy that runs the roast, he said they edited a bunch of her shit out, and then she called Howard Stern back saying, no, I nailed it, I was perfect, they didn't edit shit out. And she got a lot of attention there. Fast forward a year later, this chick is fucking everywhere. All summer long, all you're seeing is advertisements for her show, Whitney, Whitney, Whitney. Hell, she has a second show that she created, the Two Broke Girls show. It's already aired. It's a huge hit, huge ratings. I mean, she's on top of the world right now. I mean, I got some info from some people in LA that Whitney is, she's a pretty powerful person right now already. So her main show, Whitney, is coming out. You've seen all the ads, you've seen all the commercials. Shit, they've been playing it for 3 months. So how was it? I finally got to see it a little bit ahead before it airs, and it was pretty good. There was a little bit of a letdown with the premiere episode because pretty much a lot of the jokes in it, like 70% of it, you've already seen because they showed like all the big jokes on all the previews. Like her wearing the white dress, changing to the yellow dress, her in the hot little nurse's outfit. I mean, they had like five or six commercials, five or six scenes that they gave away. But, I mean, it was pretty good so far. After the first episode, is it as funny as like the big shows like Modern Family? No, it's not near as funny as Modern Family. I mean, Modern Family is just one of those shows that's just an absolute, I mean, mega show. Nothing, you know, is going to come near it. I would category it into, I would say maybe How I Met Your Mother, because it's really raunchy. It's got a lot of raunchy humor, like Sex and the City, How I Met Your Mother. But I foresee this show being a huge hit, a very huge hit, because it's... Women are going to love this show because she's like the single girl whose both parents have been married and divorced three times. She's in love with her boyfriend who's living with her, and she doesn't want to get married because she's kind of afraid to get married. And she has like these single friends. One's a wino drunk. The other one's a sexaholic. She's always talking about sex. So women are going to like it. They're going to get like a lot of these you know, inside jokes, kind of like Sex and the City. Guys are going to like it because she's pretty fucking hot. She's half naked through the whole show. She's always wearing little dresses, lingerie outfits. So, I mean, it's a win-win for, you know, male and female viewers. So, I mean, I do think this show is going to be a big hit. The first show is pretty much about, you know, you've seen the previews, her going to the wedding, and you get to meet, like, the cast of her friends. And the guy has a friend. He has a cop who, you know, is kind of a perv. He has an Indian guy. They have some racist Indian jokes in it. So they hit the racist factor there, which is funny. And, you know, something happens. They end up in the hospital. And she decides, yeah, you see that they don't want to get married yet. The cast is pretty funny. Whitney's good. Her single girlfriends are, you know, they're going to play him pretty good. The Middle Eastern guy, he's going to be pretty funny. The cop's great. The only person I really don't like is Whitney's co-star, the guy that plays her boyfriend. I mean, maybe he'll get better, but he's okay. No, they should have put somebody like a Zach Galifianakis type in it, or like a J. Chris Newberg, you know, that sort of type of guy in it, because I just don't like the way he looks, and I don't know, he's just not that funny. I mean, I did hear Whitney on Howard Stern. She absolutely loves the guy, so, I mean... But that's my only nitpick on it. I don't like him. That's Whitney. The premiere, I'd give it a 7 out of 10. It's pretty good. I mean, it's got a lot of room to grow, and I think it is going to be pretty funny. Plus, I mean, Whitney Cummings is half naked through the whole show, and she's freaking smoking hot. So set your DVRs. I give it 2 thumbs up. Set it to record Whitney. And you're not going to be disappointed. It's the first big hit of the fall season, I think. So until next time, it's Epic Conspiracy signing out.